We followed the scent into the studio, and I found Chef Elise.
That's how I met my husband. He followed the smell to my kitchen.
You know, that was a good strategy there, for sure. And this is actually your first time on the show.
It's my first time in Buffalo.
Well, that's awesome.
Right.
So tell us a little bit about your story and how you ended up here in Buffalo.
All right. Well, I'm from North Carolina. Although I'm originally from Massachusetts, Fall River, Massachusetts, just like Emeril Lagasse. And I'm actually the owner of cookwithelise.com, and I'm an author of my new book, You Never Cook Alone.
I will grab
and
it.
And my whole mission is to encourage families to cook together. 80% of families value family time around the table in the kitchen, but really only 1 in 3 achieve 4 to 5 times at night time to eat together. So. BJ's, I love BJ's, and I'm thankful to them for appreciating and embracing the mission of bringing families back to the table.
Yeah, definitely. And so you said that you travel a lot in North Carolina, but BJ's actually brought you here to Buffalo.
They brought me here to Buffalo. I'm just so thankful to them because I get to share my story with other people. A lot of people didn't realize, especially people who know me from television back home, but I actually didn't speak until I was 16 years old because I stuttered horrifically. Because,
you never know now.
I make up for it now.
Yeah, for sure.
But it was in my grandmother's kitchen and around my parents' table that I actually found refuge and I actually found my voice. And I guess you could kind of say my grandmother was a substitute for language itself for me.
Well, we want to hear more of your story for sure. We're going
to
be making some healthy tailgating food coming up.
That's right.
Yes, it's
delicious.
Going to be a turkey burger, but for now we have to send it on over to Emily Lenahan with your .com check.
And welcome back. We're with Chef Elise, first time chef ever in our kitchen. Not only first time in our kitchen, but in Buffalo. Welcome.
It's the first time in Buffalo. Thank you for having
me. We're so excited to have
you.
Thanks. And you're making some great tailgating food today.
Oh, yes. We have some wonderful ideas. We're going to get started with our turkey feta spinach burgers.
Okay.
And they're so simple. Basically, turkey is a great choice because it's mild and it's healthy.
Okay.
It just welcomes flavors.
So we and it's filling too.
It's very filling and it's so good for you. I think you'll actually like it better than beef burgers because, like I said, it just marries all the flavors very well.
Okay.
We took some frozen spinach. I get it at bulk at BJ's. I save a fortune on their organic products there.
Okay.
And then I got also at BJ's, I got some feta cheese, which is great. This is reduced fat. You won't know the difference.
Okay.
A couple of egg yolks.
Okay.
Salt and pepper. Garlic and cayenne, onion powder, and then I just mixed it all up, and then I grilled it just for 7 to 8 minutes on each side.
That's really quick, too.
It's so quick, but then we kicked it off with a green goddess mayo.
Ooh, and we're going to get to that a little bit later.
Yeah, which is so delicious.
And now when you're making a turkey burger, I know with a hamburger, you're not supposed to really smush it down too much. You're just kind of supposed to put it in your hand like a snowball. You don't want to pack it too tight.
That's an excellent question. You never really want to overwork your meat, just like you don't want to overwork flour when you're baking.
Mm-hmm.
Kind of the same principle. And so you just really want to mix it up just until it's combined.
Okay.
And when you form the burger, you can also, particularly for beef burgers, you want to put a little thumb mark in the middle.
Okay.
So that when it cooks, it doesn't puff up and bubble.
Oh, okay. Perfect tips. Here's a sneak peek at our finished product. I don't know if John can get to this. We're going to be making this coming up in our long cooking segment. For now, we're going to send things over to Emily. It smells awesome in here. Where did Jeff come from?
Jeff, Joe. Same
thing. Whatever, right? We're with Chef Elise. So excited to have you here today. Everybody
Thank
is commenting
so
on how good it smells
in
here.
Oh, I'm so glad. You know, the secret ingredient to every good recipe is love. So when people tell me everything smells good, it's like a big hug for them, you know?
Oh, how wonderful.
So we're going to make turkey burgers. You ready?
Okay.
So, like I said, turkey's great because it takes on a lot of flavors. So all I did was I took about 1.5 pounds of ground lean turkey.
Okay.
And of course I got it at BJ's, my favorite wholesale store.
Right.
And then I took their chopped spinach, which is organic. You can save 30% off on organic ingredients there. And so
that's a lot, 30%
off. It's a blessing for, you know, families. 30% off is a lot. And so then we're going to take about 1/2 cup of feta. This is reduced feta. There's no reason to get the regular. The reduced is perfect. It's nice and adds that nice little salt, you know?
Right.
And then this is how I get the burgers to be moist. This is a little trick. I take 2 egg yolks. And
okay.
You can do this with any sort of burger.
Okay.
And then I just add your egg yolks in here.
Okay.
I'm going to get messy, which is my favorite part.
Okay.
We're going to add, so because it's turkey burgers, we're going to add a lot of flavor to it. We're going to have fun. So we're going to put just a touch of cayenne, because I don't want to burn your mouth.
Okay.
And then we're going to do a tablespoon or two. I know it sounds like a lot, but it's really necessary. A tablespoon or two of onion powder. A tablespoon or two, this is how I measure, of garlic powder.
It's cooking. That's, you can have a little fun with it.
And you can, you know, do it to taste, but then we're going to add about 1 teaspoon or so of salt.
Okay.
About 1/2 teaspoon of pepper, because we already had our cayenne in there.
Okay.
And honestly, That's it. After we mix it all up, which I guess I'll start doing here, we're going to just form it into little burgers. Now, here's the key to the burgers. You want to make sure that after it's formed, you put a little indentation with your thumb in the
right,
middle,
in the
of,
middle
the,
of it.
Exactly, so that it doesn't puff up.
Okay.
You know? So, and then turkey burgers generally are about 7 minutes. On each side.
On each side, 7 minutes.
Exactly.
Okay.
Yeah. And you really want to make sure it should have, the best way is to check with an internal thermometer, you know, a meat thermometer, about 165.
Okay.
For, you know, turkey. I wouldn't go anything lower, anything higher than that. Now, here's the thing about tailgating. One of the things in my book, I talk about eventful meals. And thank you so much.
Mm-hmm.
I talk about eventful meals. The first half of the book is all about thematic recipes.
Okay.
And one of them is grilling.
Okay.
And so what I try to tell families is bring families back to the table by cooking and making it fun. So in the book, there's not just recipes, but there's stories to help illustrate how much fun you can have in the kitchen.
Okay.
So if you can't afford to take everybody to the game, you can have a tailgating party right in your backyard.
Absolutely.
You know,
and you can do it with this
pit.
Because it's, you know, six ingredients. It's easy to get together.
Easy. And instead of just prepping this, you know, ahead of time, get your kids involved. Get them to go with you to the grocery store.
And then less work for you. It's like two birds with one stone.
That's right. That's a good way to think of it. That's right. And then let the kids, you know, mix it up. Because this is so much fun.
And you also have a lot.
I'm having fun doing this.
And if people are watching and you want to, you know, kind of see what Chef Elise does, you have a large presence online.
I do. I'm so thankful for that, for all my friends who come to me every day. I post every single day at cookingwithelise.com.
Okay.
You can get the cookbook there. We also send out signed copies for anybody who wants them. And we're getting ready to launch our brand new website, which will have even more videos than it does
now.
Oh, how
wonderful.
So
and
really
Facebook
excited.
Too, right?
I love it when fans hack with me on Facebook, because bloggers, you know, when we're at home, we just love on everybody, and it's so important for them to come back and talk to us.
Right,
because
right.
We don't really know who's paying attention unless they really come back and talk to us. So.
Absolutely. So
yeah.
While you're mixing that, I'm gonna attempt to maybe, or maybe you've already
Do
made
you
it,
wanna try
our green goddess sauce.
Yes. And
we
if
have
you
about
wanna
a minute
put
left.
Okay, so here's the thing. What you want to do is, and you know what, you can put it right in here.
Shoot, okay.
That'll be delicious.
Okay.
A little extra spinach in that.
There
will be
you
great.
Go.
All we're going to do is you're going to take about a half a cup of mayonnaise.
Okay.
You can use whatever kind of mayonnaise you like.
Okay, and this is just Hellman's Real Mayo.
That's right.
Real
and
mayo.
You know what? That's how I cook, girl. Just, you don't even need to measure. Just about a half a cup. Is
okay.
It coming out?
It's
open that guy
oil.
Up if you want. Then you're going to add equal amounts of sour cream.
Okay.
There you go. About a half a cup, a little bit more.
All right.
And then just put it in there. That a girl. And then you're just going to take this sour cream here.
Okay.
And you know what sour cream does? It adds a wonderful tanginess. And that's why I love sour cream.
Okay. So we add our sour cream, and then what else?
You're just going to add your sour cream.
Where do we get the green from?
Okay. So the green comes from the cilantro, which is actually, where
is
our cilantro?
There
we go. We're going to chop that up.
Okay.
I'm going to put that in. But if you want, you're going to take a juice of a lemon. Where'd our lemon go?
Up
sweet?
There, too?
Yep. It's, okay.
It's all up there. It's out of reach because I didn't want to finish cooking
That's
this, maybe.
Okay.
I'm just
it's
kidding.
So easy. All they're going to do is they're going to juice a lemon. And then they're going to add a little bit of salt and pepper. And honest to goodness gracious, that's it.
And that's it. That's our
and
green goddess sauce.
And it is so delicious.
Okay, so we're going to put together our turkey burger
that's
here.
That's right. We'll make some more.
We'll have our second helping coming up. Emily will be in the kitchen for that. But before that, I'll have your full weather report in 2 minutes.
Welcome back. I'm joined with Chef Elise. We are going to do our second helping here. We're going to whip it up.
I'm so hungry.
I'm embarrassed to say I scarfed down half a turkey burger during the break.
I was really happy you did. You know, that's how you love people. So when you enjoy it, it just makes me feel so good, and I'm glad that you like it. Okay, so this is so simple. We are basically, we took our leftover burgers.
Right.
And we just made a sauce.
Easy
basically
enough.
We made a sauce, yeah, out of it. And it was about 5 minutes.
But the funny thing is,
day,
you said
great.
You don't like mushrooms, but this sauce is full of mushrooms, and you said you love the sauce.
I love the sauce. I love the flavor of mushrooms. I love the flavor that mushrooms impart. I'm just not a shroom fan, but my guys are.
Mm-hmm.
So it's perfect because I can make it for my guys. There's a nice flavor. They can get the meaty mushrooms. Mushrooms add a lot of beefy flavor, you know, so it really helps with the turkey Salisbury steak, which most people don't know you can use turkey for Salisbury steak.
Well, we better get cooking because we're running out of time, I'm afraid.
Okay, so all we did was we took the burgers are set aside. Just pretend that they're set aside. I melted a little bit of butter. I added the onions and the mushrooms. You can see here I just chopped up an onion. I added some sliced mushrooms. BJ's has this big, humongous thing of sliced mushrooms. It's perfect. I put some in there, and then after they were cooked and the mushrooms were nice and golden brown, I added a little bit of flour, about a couple tablespoons of flour. Then to that, here's where the flavor comes in. I added some chicken stock. Then I added a little bit of white wine, because, girl, everything's better with some white wine.
That's right.
Just make sure you get a really good white wine, because as it reduces, the flavor comes out even more, gets bolder. Do not use those cooking wines.
And
they're
you picked
awful.
A Chardonnay.
I did. I picked
like.
A dry. Then you want to add your Worcestershire. Couple
Hello.
Tablespoons. Hello, Worcestershire. Trying to say that three times backwards. And then we add a couple tablespoons of chili sauce, which adds the depth of flavor that you need.
Ooh.
You can use tomato paste. I just love, I'm a spicy girl. I love the spices. A little cayenne, some, a little bit of sage. Parsley.
Done.
Well, recipe online.
Yes,
in the cookbook.
Recipes online. Recipes in the cookbook. So,
all that on winging it.